I'm going to give you the rundown on states and articulate storyline in just 5 minutes. I'll give you some examples of what you can do, what's possible, and I'll get you started using states right away. I'm Lindsay, and I cover instructional design, e-learning development, and all things online teaching and learning. So I've already got this basic blue rectangle. This was just a basic shape I inserted from the insert shape menu. You can do whatever you want with this rectangle. You can get super creative with it. You can even make it disappear in another state. But let me tell you first what a state is. So down here on the timeline, you'll see the states item here. You'll select edit states and you'll choose new state. So Storyline has some built-in defined states. I'm going to add a hover state. And then I'm going to add a down state. And I'm going to add a visited state. Okay. Now you can edit each state. At their initial creation, all of the states are identical. Let's go ahead and change them. This is something you would often do, for example, if you want to use this as a button, though Storyline does have some nice built-in buttons. But let's change this hover state. So let's go to Format. Let's go ahead and say we want it to be orange. Down. Down state is when the user selects or clicks on it. Let's go ahead and make it purple. These are not the most attractive colors. These are just for illustration purposes. And for visited, let's make it a nice gray so it's clear that it was visited. So we got normal, hover, down, visited, hit done. When you go back to your basic timeline view, it looks exactly the same, but you can always revisit your states right here and then click edit to edit them again. All right, let's see what these do in the preview mode. Okay. Here is my preview mode. When I hover over it, it turns orange. When I go off it, it turns back to its initial state. When I hover over it and then click on it with my mouse, it turns purple. When I release, it stays orange, but then when I move off of it, it turns gray because it's been visited. So again, the initial state was blue. When you hover over, it turns orange. When you click on it, purple, and then it turns gray to show that you visited it. That's usually like a button state when you click on something and you can see that it's been visited, so you don't want to visit it again. You often use that for menu items, for example. Here's another example of when you might want to use states. Let's go ahead and insert a character. I'm going to use one of the classic Storyline characters, Samantha. We'll insert her. Now, at her basic, she's just standing with a hand on the hip there. Let's go ahead and go to edit states. And just like I did before, let's go ahead and add a hover state. So with the hover state, again, initially, she looks absolutely identical, but make sure this hover state is selected there. And then we can go to the design and we can change the pose or we can change the expression. Let's go ahead and change her pose. Let's go ahead and put her hands out to sides. Okay, so normal, there's one hand on the hip. Hover, both hands are out to the sides. Let's hit done. And let's go ahead and preview. Okay, just like my rectangle over there, when I hover over Samantha, her pose changes. How fun is that? So that is the rundown on states. You can do a lot more fun things with your states. For example, what you can do is you can actually go into the hover state and you can actually delete the character. Okay, bit of a lag, but you see the point there. Hit done. And when I go back to preview, you can see that she disappears when I hover over her. So very similarly, you can actually delete the character and you can put another image, you can put in a rectangle, you can put in audio, you can put in video. These states are really interesting because basically your imagination is the limit. What do you think? What would you use states for?